Now, if you have ovaries, like half the population, guilty, then chances are you will experience symptoms of menopause. So on International Women's Day, we thought it's a season of life worth talking about.
I think I'm having my first hot flash.
Why is such a critical part of women's health being ignored?
Bring it out onto the table. It's a natural phase of life.
Menopause has long been a taboo topic, but fed-up female celebrities have joined a growing chorus of women speaking out to remove the stigma.
When I look back to my mother's generation, I remember this kind of cardiganed coven in the kitchen whispering in the corner about the change as though Voldemort was coming.
We need to have conversations. I think it's about talking not only to blokes but also to women about what we're going through.
I'd never really had mood swings before. I'm a pretty happy sort of person. And then suddenly having this overwhelming rage that sometimes hit.
For me, the menopause really manifested itself with hot flushes, brain fog, and feeling flat.
You sweat so much, it's like the Gestapo is trying to get a confession out of you. You're basically having your own weather.
Menopause is a stage of life for women when their bodies go through hormonal changes that make puberty look like a walk in the park.
The hardest part of menopause was recognising that was what I was going through.
Because no one talks about menopause, I just thought when I was younger that it was like a flick switch. You didn't get your periods for a year and, hey, you're in menopause. And I didn't realise it was a process that could go on for years and years. And some people, it goes on for a decade.
Menopause is defined as the one-year mark after a woman's final period. The time leading into this is called perimenopause and lasts on average 4 to 6 years.
I didn't even know there was such a thing called perimenopause. I thought peri just referred to chicken.
It's a natural part of life. Yes, there are ups and downs. Some people breeze through it, some people don't. Some people can't cope at all, but it is manageable.
Most women reach menopause between the ages of 45 and 55. About 20% will have no symptoms, 60% will have mild symptoms, such as hot flushes and night sweats. For the other 20%, the symptoms are severe.
Managing menopause is one of those things I think it's probably different for everyone, but I've just found drinking less alcohol, pulling back on the spicy foods, eating smaller servings and lots of exercise.
I'm now at a point where I take HRT, I love it, I rub a gel in each morning and I take a progesterone tablet at night, and that has been a game changer for me.
There was all these medical myths for ages that HRT increased your chances of getting breast cancer, ovarian cancer. All of that's been debunked now.
We like to think about this natural progression in your life and using a natural supplement.
If you're thinking menopause is all a bit of a downer, these women do have some good news.
You get a little bit more feisty, a little bit more bolshy, a little bit more brazen, a little bit more selfish, and for the first time in your life, you can actually put yourself first.
And, well, not having a period, I mean, that's fantastic. Who doesn't want that?
The other upside to menopause, of course, is that I can just be a cranky old lady and everyone accepts it. I'm certainly going to talk about it because I'm going through it. And I think the more we see older women in the media, their lived experiences come to the fore. And I want people to know that I'm having a hot flush because of menopause, not because I'm sitting next to Sarah Harris, who is adorable.
And while menopause can't be avoided, it can certainly be managed and perhaps even embraced.
You don't have any pregnancy fears, no period cramps. You can just go and spend all that tampon money, which adds up to quite a lot.
I don't swear, but I like to go, up yours, menopause.
I say to women, just go forth and be fabulous and make sure you have a fantastic second act because, you know, if not now, when? And that may involve swinging off a chandelier with a toy boy between your teeth. I mean, who knows? Give it a whirl.
I wasn't expecting the package to finish on that note, but Kathy Lett, that was amazing. I just learned so much through watching that package and through those women teaching me and being open about everything that they've gone through, and Queen Liz just showing the absolute royalty that she is throughout that whole package.
Also, but a shout out to Peri Peri Chicken.
I know. But I actually found myself feeling a little bit of shame, or I was a bit embarrassed to know that I didn't know half of that. Like, I didn't know that menopause is the term that happens a year after your last period. I didn't know that
How long it could last? There was an audible gasp from the desk.
Everyone here was like, "Oh, what do you mean it could be that long?"
I mean, I feel like I just went through puberty, but it is coming up for us. And it is one of those things. I don't remember being taught anything in school. That my only memory of people talking about menopause as I was growing up was that my dad read an article about evening primrose oil helping, and he went and bought truckloads of the stuff. Aww. Because he has six daughters. He was like, oh, this would be a worthy investment. Yeah. But I think I was really lucky to have a dad who was willing to talk about female health issues, yeah. And you know, and the support of my, the wonderful women in my family, but it's not spoken about, and it should be taught. It should be taught not just again to women, but to all genders, so that they understand what on earth is going on.
Yeah, even just the benefits of HRT. There, I mean, Hingers and I, we were both like, oh, has all of those myths and everything been debunked surrounding that? I mean, I feel like there's just this absolute chasm in my knowledge when it comes to this, and it's going to directly affect me.
Well, a friend and I went for a walk the other day, and she said that she has this issue with her shoulder that's directly related to menopause. I had no idea that that existed, but apparently there's a lot of evidence of it. I'll find a reference for that for next time we talk about it. But it's incredible, all of these symptoms that are now being attributed to this stage of life that we just don't know enough about, and we should be talking about.
And it's still fun to be a woman.